You might think you're that God has denied you. It's only that you fail to know His timing. Praise the name of God. When you know the timing of God, you grasp the calendar of God. You will not be moved by the things of the earth. You will not be moved by the things of the world. You will not be moved by your friends what they do. Praise the name of God. You can be blessed today with 5 cars. It doesn't concern me. Wait my own time. Wait my own time. Praise the name of God. Wait my own time. I say wait my own time. You cannot imitate it. You cannot. You can have 1,000 degrees, but you cannot imitate it. Wait my time. Wait my time. Praise the name of God. Wait my time. Wait my time. Wait, I'm waiting on God. Wait my time. You cannot wait on God and you fail. It's illegal. It's illegal. Even when you end up before God, when you enter heaven, you die and God will question God. I waited on you. I never saw you. God will have a right to answer. This is why we are standing on the word of God. He said that wait upon the Lord. They that wait. Praise the name of God.
Yeah.
Praise the name of God. Yeah. When others are succeeding illegally, when others are getting money illegally, wait on God. Wait on God. Don't give up. Praise the name of God. When others are receiving jobs in the back doors, bribing, doing things that on the heart, you just wait on God. Praise the name of God. You can have it today and tomorrow you lose it, but the God that has given you the job, you can't lose it. I say you can't lose it. Praise the name of God. You can't lose it. And the day you lose it, God can sustain you. God will sustain. There's a season God sustains you without a job. I have a testimony. Praise the name of God. If you have been waiting on God, even when the enemy will try to frustrate you, because the enemy will frustrate you. When the enemy tries to frustrate you, you have been waiting on God. God gives you a sufficient grace that you can walk on that trials. You can stand that trials. You can stand that trials. God empowers you. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
Elijah had been walking with God and he wished to die. He went to a desert. When at least he expected God, Lord would send an animal. God would send. When he least expected to die, you cannot walk with God and end up in a dry place. He himself blessed himself in a dry land. But God showed himself that even in the dry land, I can still provide. Praise the name of God. You can enter dry land in desert, but with God, God can stay that desert to be a palace. One of the men that is called Isaac, when others are suffering because of drought, he himself is enjoying the harvest. Praise the name of God. You cannot wait on God and suffer the rest that we are suffering. You cannot wait on God and suffer the way others are suffering. You cannot wait on God and be sick as others have been sick. You are never at a level. It's what sustained you in Christianity. If everything happened you desire, you say it's the will of God. There are things that's not the will of God. Praise the name of God. There are things that are not the will of God. If God says that whatever is good, whatever is good, whatever is beneficial, think of that. If God tells you to think of those things, what about what is thinking for you? Can God think negatively? Can God say, I'm thinking you to get sick? No. He said by his stripes. Not we are healed, we were healed. It's a past tense. It's not a present. It's a past tense. Praise the name of God. By his stripes we were healed. It's not a present. It is a past. The sickness has no portion in me. Part of the man I listen and he empowers me. This man of God, he says that I can't imagine Christ getting sick. If Christ cannot be sick, then I cannot be sick. And he's almost in the sick that he has never been sick. This thing is real. But this thing is real. If Christ cannot cough, I cannot cough. This thing is real. your intellectual level, your wisdom level with the Word, that is what will sustain you. Praise the name of God. Praise the name of God. I want to give you a testimony. One day I was arrested by police. And I had come from waiting on God, pray. I had been in a prayer place. And in the talk, it was on 12 December. 12 December. 2017. Nimetoka tu kuomba. And nimetoka to share the word with my brother. Praise the name of God. Na nimetoka tu kwenye syndication. Immediately he left me. The police appeared. They beat me. And the Holy Ghost quickened me. Fast. Immediately arrested me. The Holy Ghost quickened me. Speaking tongues. For the buyer. Let me tell you. The man of weight is a man of mystery. Oh my. The man of weight God is a man of mystery. He can look silent, but he's not normal. He's abnormal. He can look like Hannas, but he's not Hannas. He's a man of God. He's a man of mystery. I say he's a man of mystery. Immediately they arrested me. Holy Ghost puffed me. Speak in tongues. For 30 minutes, I spoke in tongues when they are carrying me in their vehicle. Kada bosa, hinde kende baka, hinda kosa kida, aleko bakada, robo sakata, tunapiga kona, tunaenda kadeka dosi, hinde kadea. Let me tell you, when we arrive police post, 5 of them lined up, pastor, we are sorry, go home. Let me, you can arrest people, but not everybody is arrestable. Not everyone. When others, the car was full. When others are going to send, I'm going home. We cannot be treated anymore. I don't care. There is a man who has been waiting, and a man who has not been waiting. We cannot be equal. It's illegal. When they arrest another one, because about we are bank, and me, I'm arrested for nothing. We live in the same prison. It's illegal, my brother. Something is wrong. You have not been waiting on God. You have questioned God. Wait on God. I've been in the place of waiting God. I've been praying. And the Lord quickened me. I never complained. Actually, what came in my mind, how can I be with the same people who are not believing and I'm believing? And I go to jail. I begin to call those who are not born again to come to take me off. I know. There must be distinction. The Bible says I shall bring distinction for them that believe. There must be distinction somewhere. There must be distinction somewhere. I say there must be distinction somewhere. You can be. You have been waiting on God. But the things look not hard in hand. But wait. See, keep on waiting. Keep on waiting. Praise the name of God. Keep on waiting. Don't run. Because when you run, you'll fall before your time. Oh, wait on God. If it's work, you walk. If God has called you to walk, walk. Don't run. Don't run. If you're going to California, others are running, and God has told you to walk. Don't run. Walk. You'll still get there. Praise the name of God. There must be a distinction somewhere. I said there must be a distinction somewhere. There must be a distinction somewhere. Those who have been waiting, God, and those who have been waiting, God. And I'm here to tell someone who's about to give up. Don't give up. Don't give up on God. When everything looks like nothing is adding up, everything looks like nothing is good. When you've been praying, when you've been trusting God, but the answer's not come, the prayer's not been answered, but don't give up. I mean to tell you, don't give up. Don't lose hope. Don't lose hope. Trust in God. Believe in God. Hold on God. And He's about to show Himself to you. He's about to reveal that testimony to you. He's about to deliver that answer to you. Praise the name of God. When that man never gave up, God sent the second angel. The Bible says one of the prince angels, in other words, God has not one prince angel, many, but one of the prince angels was sent to deliver the prayer. You can tame Gabriel, but you cannot tame Michael. Praise the name of God. You can unless as you Gabriel with a jump message. But as I tell you, I launched Michael. You cannot tame Michael. I say you cannot tame Michael. You cannot tell Michael. Praise the name of God. Today they can enter you from close to them. But as you continue to wait on God, they cannot enter you tomorrow. Praise the name of God. You can break ranks because God has been with you. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Amen.
Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. Who did predis or preceded empowerment? When you wait, waiting preceded empowerment. Lifting power. Moses had been waiting on God for 40 days. The day he came out of the mountain, even Aaron could not comprehend Moses, the priest, who was anointed to walk with him, could not comprehend him. Oh my God. Oh my God. I say you can be waiting on God. When you begin to come out of that place, no one can comprehend you. When God lodges you, that miserable problem has to die. That problem that has sought you has to give way. That circumstance that hindered you from your next level has to give way. Because the Lord has lodged a missile. Praise the name of God. Praise Jesus. As I praise Jesus,
amen.
You've been waiting. Moses comes down. When he comes down, even the people who has been with him, the elders, the priests, the prophetess, could not hold him, could not contain him. Then something has to be done so that Moses will not kill people. Not by fighting them, by what came out of him, even physically. So in other words, waiting preceded empowerment, lifting, encounter, power. Oh, Kayaba, you can't wait and you cannot come out of that place empty. You have to come with someone. The reason why the pregnant lady, they can wait for 9 months is because they know something is coming. Ha! They can wait for 9 months in labor, in pain, carry something heavy. But wait for the 9 months, they will be jumping and celebrating. Because they know something has been waiting for us come. You can wait. And the experience, they will still carry. The experience is empty, they will still carry the second one. And the third one, and the fourth one. You know why? Because the joy after is greater than the joy before. The joy after is greater than the joy before. They can carry four. And the experience is not good, but they will still carry it. Carry is short. The period is short, but the period of fruit is long. Praise the name of God. The period of bearing is short. But the period of the fruit is long. When you begin to plant in your land, you only take a week or 2 days, depending on the size of your land. Praise the name of God. But when you begin to harvest, you can take a month. Harvest is empty, you don't go a week. Praise the name of God. So the process, hallelujah, the process, it might look small what you plant. But wait the end, it is great. So on the meat is there's a process of waiting. A product online, you pick it out online, does not become a finished product. It's still a product, a raw material. You took a raw material from a production line, that it has not become a product yet. It is still a raw material. Until it goes through the entire process to come out refined. So Christian life is a process you have to undergo, the process of training, the process of refining, the process of empowerment, the process of lifting, the process of change, the process of transformation. Peter says, after you suffer a little while, the God of glory shall restore to you. Oh man. In other words, if you are able to pass the trial, if you are able to pass the trial of suffering, after you suffer, the God of glory shall restore to you. Tell you what, you can suffer and end up miserably, die suffering. But if you can be patient on God while you suffer, after the end of suffering, the God of glory shall restore to you. Praise the name of God. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
Praise Jesus. After you suffer a little while, after you suffer a little while, the God of glory. So salvation, you cannot pull it out of salvation. You cannot make salvation complete without patience. Jesus comes and he has to be launched and he has to wait for 30 years. Jesus could have launched himself when he was 12. He could sit with the elders of church and begin to teach something they have never heard. He did not qualify himself. He did not glorify himself. He did not launch himself. He did not anoint himself. He waited for that years. And in the 12 years, he could still teach elders, church elders. Oh my. Waiting is good. I say waiting is good. Amen. Jesus said to wait another 18 years waiting. And this man could teach elders when a catching of skis. 12 years. Imagine your son of 12 years. Una catching up into the moon. Ajita apostle, ajita prophet. I'm a God of Mungu. Jesus, 30 years. Waiting. That's why the day he launched himself, the day he went to get baptized, he landed on the river Jordan. God launched him. This is my son, whom I'm well pleased. I've walked with him. I know him. There's a place you can walk with God. And the Lord begins to give you a testimony about you. I've walked with this man. He has been patient with me. He has walked with me. He has endured my cross. He has moved with me. I know my king. I'm pleased with him. This is my brother. God says, this is my son, whom I'm well pleased. Praise the name of God. Paul was taken and was taken to heaven. And Paul says that God showed me the things that even I'm not supposed to happen. But because of that, God put a thorn in my flesh. A thorn. In other words, if the thorn was not there, this man would have written me. And the Jacob said, I went to heaven. You know I went to heaven. But he was patient. The thorn was there. You put him on patient. On what? Wait, break. Any in America, break. You have not seen me yet. I'm about to show you. Wait. There's a place of wait. And that place will come out revived. You'll come out in power. You'll come out lifted. I've listened to Apostle Suleiman. When he began ministry, he began to preach. He began with 9 people. He went to 16. He reached somewhere, he closed the church. Praise the name of God. He closed that church. He went and opened another church. When he went to open another church, he prayed for 90 days. When he was in the place of dying, other pastors told him, you will die. You cannot finish dying. 90 days, you will die. When he came out of 90 days, he looked like a skeleton. But the day he went to preach, the church next, closed their church, came to his church. It's a place of knowledge you can go. You become terrorizer. Imagine pastor nafunga kanisa pale na kwambia nimekuletea washirika. Sisi ni mama pastor na form shirika. Because you've been in the place of knowledge. You've been in the place of knowledge. Place of knowledge. That's why today, he waited for his knowledge. The first launching was not his. That's why he was able to close the church. The second launching, you cannot hold him. He's everywhere. Praise the name of God. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
You can wait your time. And when God launches you, oh my God. So Ishmael began ministry when he's over 40 years. Right? Right? Look at where she is today. Maybe she has begun the ministry in 20s. She could have died. She could have died, but she had to wait. God had to groom her. God had to wait to work on her until she that age that she can bear. There's a season you can launch yourself without knowing the season of God. And after second year, you die. Praise the name of God. There's a place of waiting. I heard a lady was saying, Bishop Yeri was saying, that it takes a break from ministry. From ministry. It takes a break, literally a break. Not to his country, he flies. And he goes to a place just to pray. He's not going anywhere. He's not reading anything. Even he has hired people to read nation for him, gazette for him, and tell him what is happening. He begins to pray for an entire week. For when he comes, will you not listen? Will you not walk by his step? Will you not look for his cover? He has been in the place of Lord Jesus. He has been the blessed virgin. Praise the name of God. Amen. Praise the name of God. Amen. Hallelujah. You must be in the place of lodging. You must be in the place of waiting. And I'm here to speak to someone who is about to give up. You're about to give up for that situation. You have waited on God. You have prayed. You have trusted on God. You have cried to God. You have believed on God. But something is not happening. And you're about to give up. I'm here to tell you, don't give up. Your time is about to come. I say your time is about to come.
Amen.
I say your time is about to come.
Amen.
Don't give up. Things may not go out right now. You might have gone through 1,000 breakups. But wait, don't give up on marriage. Wait, the right man is coming. Wait, God lodges you. The right person is coming. Praise the name of God. You can have 10 breakups. Wait the right time of God. God is, don't give up. Maybe you saw your parents, the way they were, the marriage were. You decided you're not going to get married. You decide to give up on that marriage. Wait for time for your time. You ask myself something different. Praise the name of God. You must have something decent. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Your business is not picking. Others are picking. Wamenda kwa waganga, their business are picking. Wait the test of time. When you ask it be breaking, they ask it be called down. Because the two cannot contend. One has to borrow. So one has to borrow. Where is the name of God? Because if they see that the river is what, they see that castle is right down. If they will not begin to live to have, there must be someone who will be going up, down. Where is the name of God? You go up, someone go down. You cannot wait. And when God begins to launch you, someone begins to contend with you. They will die. I say they will die. Oh my. Oh my. Oh my. I love giving you an example with Apostle Solomon because I listen to him so much. Let me give you this testimony. He had been in the place of prayer. And he had, I called my whole conference. And after conference, he's taking a minister of God home. And he, and I believe that to miss what I can see. And on the way, they met the robbers. I jacked the robber. So the robbers, I jacked the robber. And they begin to rob everybody. So as you come, you're being stopped, you park your car. Everything you have is taken. And so when they arrived, and the robbers stopped them, the pastor he carried, and is the one who administered in the church. Fall prostrate on the ground. You have to fall prostrate on the ground. Come up, come down and lie down. But he refused to lie down. When he came out, the man went to open his door. He told him, "Go open my door. I come out myself." When he stepped out, he said, "Do you know who I am? Apostle Suleiman. Oh, bad market. Bad market. Bad market." That person can stop you. And after he knows who you are, he says that is a bad market.